All right, I am standing here at SIGGRAPH with Stephen of Massive Software. Nice to see you again.
Nice to be here.
It's been a year since we last spoke, and a lot has been going on with Massive. Can you give me a little bit of a lay of the land in terms of what's new with 9.0?
Yep, well, we've just announced 9.0, and we've got basically two kinds of things in 9.0. We've got a lot of new placement stuff, so I wanted to figure out how to do escalators, actually. And so in figuring that out, I came up with a whole load of other stuff that ended up making placement much easier. And so even if you're doing a huge scene now, you could just adjust the entire scene with one slider, and that's cool. But the escalators are fun.
That's awesome. And it also sounds like you are you're bringing in more compatibility across multiple platforms with this universal plugin.
Yeah. So we have a lot of requests for support for things like Blender, Mantra, Cinema 4D, pretty much everything. And we don't have time to support everything. And we have a very efficient render pipeline, but it does require there to be a plugin for each renderer. And so what I thought was, okay, how about we make a renderer plugin that is really, really easy to integrate? So you just have to write about half a dozen functions of glue code, and then you can get it working with any renderer. And in fact, we gave this a couple of weeks ago to Theory Studios, who are using Massive on Man in the High Castle. And within a few days, they not only got it rendering with Blender, but they got the agents turning up in the viewport in Blender.
Is there anything else about 9.0 that you want to call out that people might be particularly excited for?
Well, anyone who's a Massive nerd would be excited about some of the features in there, like a new way of connecting nodes. But if you don't know what the brain nodes look like, then you'll just be going, huh?
Well, then, in that case, I want to move on to the horses and hipsters that we were discussing earlier.
Right.
Tell me about the new agents that are out.
Okay, well, firstly, we've revamped all of our agents. So we wanted to make them higher quality, and we've redone all the texture maps, and we used Marvelous Designer, actually, to get really natural folds and creases, and then bake that back into bump maps. We've given them glasses, beards, hats, and many more accessories than they had before. And yeah, some of them look like hipsters, but you can turn that off.
It's just a sign of the times. You're staying relevant.
That's right. If you're going to have like an ArcViz scene, then you've got to make it look like it was shot this year and not in the 90s or something.
That's wonderful. And now people can create a stampede of horses, as many as they want, galloping through. And this is the first time, right, that this has become possible.
Yeah, we're very excited about the horse agent. I've wanted to do it for years. It's just a huge deal. It was very expensive. We did it with Profile/Giant, you know, who are the best mocap people in the world. And I just decided eventually, okay, I'll just call them up and we'll book a soundstage and do it, because we just got to do it. And ever since Lord of the Rings, I knew we needed to have a horse and rider agent, and now we've got it.
That is amazing. So how long did that process take, getting the mocap?
Well, there was planning for quite some time,
yeah.
And then it took over a year to get the soundstage, actually, because the one that we were trying to get kept getting booked up, and then Profile said, well, Jim Cameron's Lightstorm stage is available now, and that's actually got the best cameras in the world. And so we thought, okay, we'll go with that. And then, but we really wanted to get those full-on gallops. And so you're not going to get that in any stage. So we also went to the ranch, and the people that supply the horses, they're the number one Hollywood horse supplier. So we set up at their ranch, and we got exactly what we wanted. Amazingly, one of the horses was just doing everything right. And I'd been told by people who've done the horse mocap for Weta and another place that you're never going to get the horse to put its feet in the right place. You're just going to have to go with what you get. But this horse did just what we wanted.
No kidding.
Yeah.
A true professional. And were they dressed with the proper attire? How did that work out with the mocap suits and equipment?
Well, they don't actually have the neoprene sort of wetsuit look thing
okay.
for the horses. That would be kind of cool, but I don't think the horses would like it.
Yeah.
So they just glue the markers onto the horse with some very animal-friendly glue. Then you have to keep sticking them back on, because as soon as the horse shakes or whatever, then the markers are all over the place.
Yeah. Well, this is amazing, Stephen. I'm so glad to hear that things have been going so well at Massive, and it sounds like there's a lot of updates that our audience will look forward to. Anything else you want to call out, or at least the website that they can go to find out more information?
Well, you can always go to www.massivesoftware.com. You could probably find us on Facebook and Twitter as well.